T-Tube. News Today. T-Tube is working to be the voice for the voiceless. Subscribe, share and comment our channel. Thank you. News Headlines. Africa, Ethiopia, intentional mass starvation, humanitarian truce in Tigray is at stake Wednesday, 20 April 2022. Conflict continues between Amhara and Oromo in different fronts. Many Oromo civilians are being massacred by Amhara Fano and Shifter in Wolo. More than 54 Tigrayan detainees in have died by pandemic diseases, malnutrition and lack of medicen.
Tigray war claims the lives of at least 1,900 children through malnutrition. Doctors say the number is likely to be higher in the war-torn Ethiopian region. 65% of people in Arab NE Tigray facing extreme food insecurity, 87,000 people displaced within eastern zone in March, UN.
American lawmaker urges Biden to cement ties with Ethiopian government as aid arrives in Tigray. The friendly group left Africa, Ethiopia, intentional mass starvation, humanitarian truce in Tigray is at stake. Pharmacy, Addis Ababa, Agenzia Fides, hundreds of thousands of Tigrayans are dying of hunger. The humanitarian truce that began on March 24 is already at stake. The government has allowed only one aid convoy to enter Tigray, the first since mid-December 2021, and has refused any permission until the Tigray People's Liberation Front (TPLF) has not withdrawn to the region. The TPLF wants aid to flow freely before withdrawing completely, along with the withdrawal of Amhara forces from western Tigray. Without a breakthrough to ease the blockade, the horror of ethnic cleansing will be accompanied by an equally grotesque abuse, deliberate mass starvation. This is what emerged from an in-depth investigation by Human Rights Watch and Amnesty International, which, in a joint report, published on April 6, conclude that the authorities in the Amhara region have systematically killed or expelled hundreds of thousands of people of Tigrayan origin from the territory seized by Tigray since the beginning of the war. The humanitarian situation in Tigray continues to worsen. The passage through the humanitarian corridors through which the United Nations, the government or other agencies try to bring food into the country, is sometimes blocked and we do not know for sure by whom, said the Archbishop of Addis Ababa, Cardinal Burhaniyesus Surafil. As a result, continues the Cardinal, the suffering of the people is increasing. As the Conference of Catholic Bishops of Ethiopia, we have launched appeals to our Catholic network throughout the world, in particular through Caritas Internationalis. Only a fortnight ago we asked for money to help our people, not only in Tigray, but also in neighboring areas. The drought, see Fides, 7 April 2022, has worsened due to climate change. The humanitarian crisis is huge and people are in dire need of help. The Cardinal concluded his reflection by emphasizing that Ethiopia should not be seen as a country of conflict or war. We have many challenges here in Ethiopia, but I believe and trust in the prayers of people who have been united for centuries, who have married and lived as Ethiopians. Our hope is that soon our peoples will soon become one again. The disputed area, officially known as Western Tigray before the war, is today probably the main obstacle to ending the conflict. App, Agenzia Fides, 20 April 2022, this bishop was the beginner of Tigray genocide. He has been using as the tool of the butcher Abiy Ahmed Ali. He repeatedly threatened Tigray and SPP on Sid the Clid raping army in collaboration with Ethiopian Orthodox Church. There are so many photographs he aired on the beginning of the genocide. Conflict continues between Amhara and Oromo in different fronts. Many Oromo civilians are being massacred by Amhara Fano and Shifter in Wolo. More than 54 Tigrayan detainees in have died by pandemic diseases, malnutrition and lack of medicen. The butcher Abiy Ahmed Ali has been prisoning different irregular Shifter Amhara and Fano while they are destroying and robbing Tigrayan properties in different parts of Ethiopia. Now, they have been continuously killing the innocent people of Wolo Oromo because of their identity, and continuous clashes have been registered in the past 5 days. Tens of Wolo Oromo farmers and students have massacred daily. At the same situation, the butcher Abiy Ahmed has been detaining Tigrayan retuned from Saudi Arabia in indifferent concentration camps. Out of them, more than 54 civilians have died because of malnutrition, hunger, pandemic and lack of medicine. While this horror is continuing, the world is silent and some are praising the genociders of allowing less than 4% the humanitarian assistance convoy into Mekelle. Tichu Bagud, the world's is liable of not stopping Tigray genocide and Ethiopian continuing civil war sponsored by the World Bank.
Tigray war claims the lives of at least 1,900 children through malnutrition. Doctors say the number is likely to be higher in the war-torn Ethiopian region. Associated Press, April 20, 2022. At least 1,900 children under the age of 5 have died from malnutrition in Ethiopia's Tigray region in the past year. According to a study carried out by local health officials and seen by the Associated Press, the deaths were recorded at health centers across the war-torn region between June last year and April 1. Western Tigray, which is under the control of forces from the neighboring Amhara region, was not included in the survey. The doctor involved in the study said the true number of child deaths from malnutrition is likely to be higher because most families are unable to bring their children to health centers because of transportation challenges. Most hunger deaths go unrecorded, he said. Because we cannot access most areas, we do not know what is happening on the community level, said the doctor, who requested anonymity for fear of reprisals. These are simply the deaths we have managed to record in health facilities. Aid convoy arrives in Ethiopia's Tigray after 3 months' pause. Tigray has been cut off from the rest of Ethiopia since June, when fighters from the Tigray People's Liberation Front, or TPLF, recaptured most of the region as federal forces defeated by TDF. Banking services, phone lines and road links are all down in the region, a situation the UN has said amounts to a de facto blockade. The Ethiopian authorities insist or lied there is no deliberate effort to target Tigrayan civilians, but this is complete lie, because the butcher Abiy Ahmed and the sadist Asius Afewerki are intentionally killing the people of Tigray suing different crimed. They have urged Tigrayan fighters to surrender. This is clearly using man-made starvation as a means of war. This is war crime and crime against humanity, which is against the international humanitarian law. Mass starvation has to be condemned and the perpetrators and genociders have to be liable of their crimes. More than 90% of Tigray's 5.5 million people require humanitarian assistance, including 115,000 children who are severely malnourished, according to UN figures. Civil servants have not been paid in months. Many have run out of cash to buy food and other goods because banking services have been shut down. The children of families living in urban areas are especially at risk of malnutrition, as their parents do not have farmland to grow food, according to Tigrayan health officials. The war in Tigray enters its second year. About 700,000 people in Tigray are in the grip of famine-like conditions, owing to the obstruction of aid, U.S. officials estimate. Ethiopia's federal government unilaterally declared a surprise humanitarian truce on March 24, an announcement it said would allow aid to flow into Tigray. But nearly 1 month later, only 4 convoys of around 80 food lorries have entered the region. Literally nothing has changed, said an aid worker who recently visited Tigray. We are just seeing a handful of trucks. These trucks are better than nothing, but they are not going to feed the millions of people who need aid. An estimated 2,000 lorries of food must enter Tigray every week to meet the region's needs, a UN official said. That is a sharp increase from the previous assessment of 600 a week. Just 3% of the vegetable seeds and 10% of the fertilizer required for the current planting season have reached Tigray, according to UN figures, raising fears of a poor harvest that will deepen the region's hunger crisis. Several health officials in Tigray say they simply do not have enough supplies to treat many patients they encounter. Some said shortages are so dire that patients' relatives must personally buy medicine from private pharmacies at inflated prices and bring them to the hospital before their family members can be treated. Tens of thousands of people have been killed in the war, according to estimates by international aid groups. But there is little hope for peace talks as the Ethiopian authorities have outlawed the TPLF, effectively making its leaders fugitives. Tigray elites say the butcher Abiy Ahmed and the man-eating Amhara shifters in collaboration with the distinguished African dictator Isaias Afwerki are preparing for further genocide as they were effectively defeated in different fronts.
65% of people in Arab, northeast Tigray facing extreme food insecurity, 87,000 people displaced within eastern zone in March, UN. Arab, also referred to as Arab land or Adi Arab, Adi Irobi, Irobi Diki, in Tigrinya, Saho, is located in the northeastern part of Tigray. It borders Eritrea to the north, Ethiopia's Afar region to the east, and the remainder of Tigray to the southwest. Arab is part of a region in northeastern Tigray historically called Agaim, which had Adigrat as its capital. Source OMNA Tigray, picture, Professor Kindia Gabrihiwot, 2019 Archive Addis Abeba, in Arab Wereda, in northeastern Tigray, reports indicate over 33,000 people, 65% of the Wereda population, are facing extreme food insecurity and have received limited assistance, the UNOCHA said. The Arab community are one of the two minority groups in Tigray regional state. The Cunmps are the other minority group in Tigray. Last week, a Simba Democratic Party, ADP, an opposition party based in Tigray state, pleaded for the release of its chairman, Dori Azgedem, who is in police custody in the capital Addis Abeba for more than 15 months. A Simba is an opposition political party from Tigray state that is representing the Arab community. It has been outspoken about the occupation by Eritrean army of the area and the Arab community since Ethiopia's civil war began in November 2020. The UN report also said that in March reportedly over 87,000 people were displaced within eastern zone due to insecurity and limited assistance. Furthermore, hostilities in Shire area, northwestern zone led to civilian injuries and reports of damages to the premises of one aid partner. Meanwhile, armed hostilities continued in various hotspots along the border with Eritrea. Additionally, clashes were reported along the border with Sudan in Barakat, close to the Hamdiyet border crossing, and near May Kadra and Humara areas, forcing humanitarian staff to temporarily relocate to safer areas. Access to Kafta Humara, Kareret, May Gaba, Welkate, and surrounding areas remains insecure, and many vulnerable people have not received assistance for months and are believed to be in dire need of humanitarian aid and protection services. American lawmaker urges Biden to cement ties with Ethiopian government as aid arrives in Tigray. A United States lawmaker has welcomed the said to be successful delivery of humanitarian aid into the northern region of Tigray, calling on President Joe Biden's administration to advance relations with the government of Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed in Addis Ababa. While the blockade is continuing and people are still dying, less than 4% of the aid is arrived. April 20, 2022. Last week, the government announced a successful arrival of Mekelle-bound aid convoy belonging to the World Food Programme, WFP, following reports that the rebel Tigray People's Liberation Front, TPLF, were undermining aid entry into Tigray region. In a statement, Senator Mark Warner hailed the aid arrival into Tigray as a positive progress made by the government in Addis Ababa and called on the Biden administration to cement ties with Ethiopian government in realizing peace and development. Continued efforts to expand access to the Tigray region are positive progress, as humanitarian organizations work to provide needed aid, Senator Mark wrote on Twitter yesterday. It's vital that the U.S. advance diplomatic efforts with the Ethiopian government, and support humanitarian and economic initiatives for the Ethiopian people, the U.S. lawmaker further added. However, this is fake. Only less than 4% of the needed aid has been arrived into Tigray. People are dying by starvation caused as a result of man-made hunger. The Brother Abiy Ahmed Ali invaded Tigray and killing its people and blocked it from aid, so what is the progress that is making some corrupted lawyers to jock on the pains our people?